Hey everybody, welcome to the AMD Gaming Channel. We're excited to bring you the second episode of AMD Now Playing. So Adam, why don't you tell us about what we're talking about today?
Yeah, to get started, we'll take a look at the new availability of the AMD Radeon RX 7900 GRE graphics card. We'll check out how it performs in the latest games and in some of your favorite AI workloads. Following that, we'll do a quick update with our AMD Software Adrenalin Edition and see what's new in our two most recent driver updates.
I'm excited, so let's dive right in.
Getting started with today's episode, we're going to take a look at the AMD Radeon RX 7900 GRE graphics card, which is now available globally from our AIB partners. This graphics card is great for maxing out the latest games on your 1440p high refresh rate display. And what's even better is when you use our groundbreaking AMD Arden A3 architecture, AMD software, and 16GB of video memory, you're actually able to experience some great 4K gaming experiences. At a starting price of just $549, this is a fantastic option to dive into the latest games. From a specs perspective, this graphics card features 80 unified Arden A3 compute units, which means you have 80 second generation ray tracing accelerators and 160 AI accelerators, which have been specially optimized for FP16 inference. It features 16GB of video memory along a 256-bit memory bus, meaning you're future-proof for years to come. As with all AMD Radeon RX 7900 series graphics cards, you get the latest innovations from the Radeon team, including AV1 encoding, DisplayPort 2.1, all at a power bracket of about 260 watts. It's a great plug-and-play upgrade for any enthusiast. Now look, I could sit here and talk about specs all day, but I know you probably care about how this card performs in games. If we look at 1440p at some of the most popular titles to come out over the past year, we can say that this card delivers a great gaming experience, especially when compared to product offerings from the competition at the same price point. If we look at what the competition has to offer for $50 more, on average, we actually deliver the same performance and trade blows quite nicely.
If you're looking to take your performance to the next level with this graphics card, we're pleased to announce that FSR is now available in over 350 titles. What's even more exciting is that our latest technology in FSR3 now support in 36 available and upcoming games. If your favorite titles don't already have that awesome AMD FSR or FSR3 support, we're excited to share that in our latest January software driver, we've brought the power of AMD Fluid Motion Frames right into AMD HyperRX. So when you toggle on AMD HyperRX to use it across thousands of games, you can achieve that performance need to dive into higher resolution gaming across your whole library. In this latest driver, not only are we bringing great performance features, but also awesome video enhancement features. You know that gaming isn't all about just getting those highlights, but also sharing those with your friends. And so in this latest driver, we're introducing new video enhancement technologies. Within the latest version of AMD software is a new video upscale toggle. Users can enable this toggle from the graphics tab to enjoy improved sharpness and clarity within their videos. The support extends to apps such as Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, Windows Media Player, and more, with support extending all the way to 4K resolution, providing you with better fidelity and clarity, particularly in your videos with lower quality. What's also updated is our encode quality and our in-game text quality, so that when you're streaming to users, they'll be able to see your enemies on your radar more clearly, or they'll be able to see you launching that Eagle airstrike on your own teammates even more sharper. So if you're looking to take advantage of these great performance features and awesome video enhancement technologies, make sure that your AMD software is up to date so that you can get the best possible gaming experiences.
Now, if you aren't just interested in gaming and creating and you want to start stepping to some AI workloads, I got some great news for you. The 7900 GRE runs these workloads incredibly well. The most popular offline workloads that we're seeing in the community today are text-to-image services similar to DALL-E or Midjourney and large language models. Imagine offline versions of ChatGPT. Now, for text-to-image performance, that relies very heavily on FP16 performance, and the 160 AI accelerators on the Radeon RX 7900 GRE have been optimized specifically for FP16, giving you great performance. The 7900 GRE, using the default settings, is able to render images in less than a second on average, getting great performance. Additionally, if you're into running large language models, so again, this is similar to an offline version of ChatGPT, the larger models require more video memory, and the larger models really just contain more inputs and parameters. When looking at the 16GB of video memory on the 7900 GRE, we're actually able to get great performance when using some of these larger models, and deliver incredibly competitive performance versus the competition. The AMD Radeon RX 7900 GRE, as well as all of our AMD Radeon RX 7000 series cards, are AI ready. They feature great compute performance in some of those FP16 workloads, they have plenty of video memory for the larger models, and they have great application and framework support across the entire ecosystem. If you're an AI enthusiast and want to try out these latest experiences on Radeon, the Radeon RX 700 GRE is a great option.
We've covered a lot in today's episode, with the newest Radeon RX 7900 GRE delivering great performance for 1440p gamers, as well as the newest and awesome updates to AMD software. Make sure that your AMD software is up to date to enjoy these great features. And if you want to learn more, check out the links in the description below to the blogs that cover a recap of what we talked about today.
Be sure to like and subscribe and leave whatever comments you have down below. We love interacting with you and hearing your questions. Until then, we'll see you on the next episode of AMD Now Playing.